Knives, guns, and even stranger items, all things people in Kansas City try to carry onto a plane.
Tonight, the TSA shows us the most extreme things passengers want to sneak past security. And KMBC 9's Cliff Judy is live now from KCI. Cliff?
Kelly, the TSA says the overwhelming majority of the prohibited items that people are trying to bring on planes are still things like this: bottled water, shampoo, liquids that are too big to be allowed on the plane. What we saw today was no bottled water. Before you're ever in the air at KCI Airport, we all know the drill: security checkpoints and baggage checks that became far more strict in the last 12 years. Wednesday, the TSA spread out Kansas City's most bizarre attempted stowaways.
I don't know. Been told and told and told that you can't get through the airport with that, and here it lays.
It's still surprising, yes.
Angela Brooks worked at KCI the last 22 years. She says these are real prohibited items passengers tried to carry on Kansas City planes in the last couple of years.
The firearms, the real ones, are about once a month. These type of items, it's about once a day, I'd say, yeah.
Makes you feel good that you're doing your job and you know these things are out there. And people do bring.
While these guns are all fake, for instance, the Derringer's a belt buckle, the TSA says people still try to bring real firearms on board. A dozen at KCI last year and 13 in 2011. Other weapons are, say, less obvious: hidden knives and fake pens or even lipstick.
Okay, that one on a plane?
Whether we showed other passengers pictures of prohibited items.
When you see throwing stars and grenades, even if they're fake grenades, that's no. That's silly.
Or they couldn't help but stare as they walked by.
Knives, pistols, and a hammer.
Few understood why anyone would think they could get by security with weapons like these.
I don't know. Testing the system.
See what they can get away with. Say, you know, are they really paying attention? Well, apparently they are.
They are making sure the takeoff happens without certain carry-ons. Now, the TSA says the passengers usually just claim that those prohibited items were a mistake. For instance, someone who's used to carrying a knife on them, forgetting to have put it into their checked baggage. The TSA has a section on their website where you can type in anything and find out whether it's banned on an airplane. We have a link to that on our website, KMBC.com. Back to you in studio.
All right, thank you, Cliff. Now, the TSA says you can face a fine for trying to bring certain items on a plane. When they confiscate real firearms, they do hand those guns over to law enforcement. Police decide if there will be a citation or an arrest.